Hello everyone, in this lecture I am just going to demonstrate timer interrupt mode using LED in STM32F446RE microcontroller with the help of STM32CubeMX. Let's get started. Let's configure our microcontroller as per our requirement. Open the STM32CubeMX software. Now click on File and then click New Project. Now you will get a tab where you can select the microcontroller as per your requirement. Now here you can see there is a tab named Board Selector. So this tab is used for selecting the board that is available in the STM series microcontroller. So in my case, I'm using Nucleo F446RE development board. So you can find these kinds of board over here. But if you are using a custom made board as per your requirement, you just want to select the MCU right over here. Click on the MCU selector tab. And here you just want to type in the microcontroller name that you are using. In my case, I am just going to use STM32F446RE. So I am just going to select the microcontroller as if I am going to use a custom made board, but I am using the Nucleo F446RE development board. So double click on this microcontroller name to select the microcontroller. So here you can see you will get the microcontroller with all the pins uninitialized. So in the previous two lectures, we learned how a timer interrupt mode works in ST microcontrollers, and also we learned and calculated the prescaler value as well as the period value for producing 1 second interrupt in timer 6 peripheral of our microcontroller, right? That is nothing but the prescaler for scaling down the frequency of the timer to 1 kHz is 15999. And the period for setting the timer interrupt for every 1 second is 1000 value. So I'm just going to use those two values for configuring my timer in timer interrupt mode, and I will be using the onboard LED that is available in the Nucleo board for demonstrating this timer. So I'm just going to configure the PA5 as output. So regarding the clock, so come to the clock configuration, I'm not going to change anything over here. I'm going to use the same HSI clock that is 16 MHz. So you can see APB2 timer clocks is also running at 16, and APB1 timer clocks is also running at 16. As we learned that our timer 6, that is the basic timer, is running under this APB1 timer clock that we discussed in the previous lecture, right? So I'm not going to touch here anything. So we are just going to see how we can configure the timer in interrupt mode. Click on the timer over here and then click on the TIM6. Check this box activated. Now under the configuration, you can see the prescaler value. This is a 16-bit prescaler register. So you can add a value between 0 to 65535 here. So we calculated the prescaler value in the previous lecture, that is 15999, for scaling down the timer clock to 1 kHz. So I'm adding here 15999, and the period value we found out to be 1000 counts for producing interrupt for every 1 second delay. So I'm just going to give the period value here. This is also a 16-bit value. So that's all about the configuration for timer. The timer's clock is scaled down to 1 kHz and it will run up to a maximum of 1000 milliseconds, that is 1 second. And now you just want to enable the interrupt for the timer. That can be done by clicking on the NVIC settings tab here. Click on this and you want to check this box, that is TIM6 global interrupt and DAC1, DAC2 error interrupts. If you are not enabling this, the interrupt for the timer will not be functioning and the code for the interrupt handler will not be configured using the CubeMX. So you just want to check this box. So that's all about the configurations that you need to do for configuring the timer in interrupt mode. Now go to the project manager tab, give a name for the project, Select the toolchain ID to MDK ARM5. Copy only necessary files. And that's all about the configurations. Click on the generate code to generate the code necessary. Now open this timer interrupt keel file. So all the configurations has been done by the CubeMX software. All we need to do is we just want to start the timer and we want to write the code inside the interrupt handler. So our logic is simple. I am just going to toggle the state of the onboard LED counter to PA5 of my microcontroller for every 1 second using timer interrupt. So come into the STM32IT.c. So here you will find the timer handler. So this is the timer interrupt handler that is generated by the CubeMX. So things that you want to perform or do when a timer interrupt rises that you want to write inside this handler. So I just want to toggle the state of the pin PA5, that is the onboard LED pin in my Nucleo board. So I'm just going to write all GPIO toggle pin GPIOA GPIO pin 5. So whenever the timer interrupt occurs, the state of the PA5 will be toggled. If it is high, it will become low. If it is low, it will become high. So here I just want to start the timer. So that can be done by hall timp base start IT. So this is the function call for starting the timer in interrupt mode. So you just want to pass the address of the handle variable that is created over here. You can see this variable will be created automatically by the CubeMX when you configure a timer. So you just want to pass this variable over here. So you just want to pass the address of this variable. So add an ampersand symbol before this. So that's all about this. You have started the timer. Now I will explain about the working principle of this code. Now when the program starts, it will execute all the things over here, and when the program reaches here, it will start the timer 6 in interrupt mode and it enters into the while of 1. Nothing is written here, so it will stay here stagnant. After execution of this line, the timer starts counting from 0 and it reaches 1000 as we set the period value to be 1000 over here. 1000. So after reaching 1000, that is exactly the 1000 will be reached as per our prescaler value after 1 second. So after 1 second, when it reaches 1000 value, the timer overflow occurs and it will interrupt the processor. So the processor pauses all the process that it was doing here and it will enter into this handler, that is the timer interrupt handler, and it will execute all the code available here, and after finishing this, it will come back to the main function and it will resume the process it left here. So this is the concept. So again and again, for every second when the interrupt handler is called, the state of the LED connected to PA5 will be toggled. So the LED will be blinking for every 1 second using timer interrupt mode. So this is the working principle of this code. I am compiling the code. The code has been successfully built with 0 errors and 0 warnings. Now connect the Nucleo board to the PC through USB cable and then click on this download icon for downloading the flash to the microcontroller. Now the flash has been successfully downloaded to the microcontroller. Now click on the reset button to run the program in the microcontroller. To start the program in our microcontroller, reset the controller. And you can see our inbuilt LED in our development board is blinking with a time interval of 1 second using timer interrupt. Thanks for watching.